Hi, today we're out with the XP Deus with a 13-inch coil. As you can see, we're on a lovely pasture site. Targets, I hope, are going to be deep, so we're going to have a little tweak around. We're going to start off in the hot program, then we may change frequencies or we may change to the pitch mode and just see what sort of target responses we get. So, the machine switched on. Let's start off by turning the sensitivity up for the site conditions. I'm raising the sensitivity. I've got a radio transmitter behind me. That's too high, you can hear it chattering. So I'm coming down using the minus button. About 90, which is the factory preset. So here we go, let's start detecting. Obviously low tone iron. What I'm going to do now is go from 11 kilohertz to 7 kilohertz. I might even drop it down lower because I very rarely use the lower kilohertz. They tend to be ignored. Okay, you're probably not going to be fussed by foil and tiny targets, but I'm going to try and work that to my advantage. So I'm using a lower frequency and just hopefully pick up the bigger targets at depth. I don't know whether it's going to work out or not, but it's got to be worth a try. Like I say, I normally try the lower frequencies and then get bored and go back onto the 11 or the 17. But I'm going to try and discipline myself here and just stick with it and see if we can pull something out. Oh dear. That's a massive signal. That's 88 on the meter. Coca-Cola, anyone? We'll dig it out anyway. Still in the hole, so perhaps it's not a Coke can. I'm out. That's interesting. Looks like it could be off the bottom of a Second World War bomb or something like that. I've seen things like this before. So yeah, about 9 inches down, I'd say, with a whacking great signal. So don't forget, we're still in 7 kilohertz here. So if I can find stuff like that, but being older artifacts, I'll be chuffed to bits. Yeah, gonna have a go at that. Nice and repeatable. ...85 on the meter. Getting closer, let's have some more out. Perfect. That'll do, hammer coin. Or a milled silver. It's very thin and it's completely worn, so I've no idea what it is. It's thin enough to be probably Elizabeth or something like that. But what a bright signal, and that was a good 7-8 inches down. 7 kilohertz again. Beautiful. 68.71 on the meter. Let's have some more out. No, time for the garret. Let's have a little sniff around with that, see what we can find. Exactly at the bottom of the hole. I'm going to go quite careful now because I'm getting to a depth where some of the decent stuff's been found. So I just don't want to risk damaging it. Are you ready for this? Don't ask me what it is, but that's the sort of target we're looking for using 7 kilohertz. We're getting the depth, we can get the lumpier stuff, the higher conductors, but whatever it is, I can tell you that's old. It looks a bit like an early belt buckle or something like that. I'm terrible at identifying things, but there's slight signs of gilding on it. It's drying out a little bit now. Again, that was 10 inches down and that gave a whacking great signal. So let's plod on, see if we can get a few more of them. Quite a desperate signal there. Stick it in pinpoint. Now that's really quiet in pinpoint. Remember, we're still on 7 kilohertz. It's livening it up a little bit. I'll have a bit more out. Back in the hole, but that's the low conductor. Oh, lost it. Ah, there it is. I've knocked it around a bit, look. I'm not sure what it is. I don't want to rub it too much now I've seen it. I wonder if you can get a close-up of that. Really difficult to see now it's drying out, but when I wiped it I could see just something written on it. But again, 7 kilohertz and you're finding wafer thin targets like that, so it's definitely worth giving a try. Although we're looking for the bigger targets, the deeper targets, that's just our luck that we find something small and thin. But you've got to bear in mind that if a field's been done so many times, there's not necessarily big or deep targets there. So, you know, the machine will only find it if they're there. But we're going to press on a little bit more and see if we can come up with something else. Okay, we're just getting 25 flicking up, but I'm going to ignore that because it could be anything. Wow. Still no meter reading. That's weird. Let's have some more out. ...36 on a meter now. That's a low conductor. I can see it, look. Possibly a washer, I'm not sure. But definitely non-ferrous. Look at the depth. 7 inches down. Again, 7 kilohertz. Now what I'm going to do now is give this program a little bit of a tweak. I want it more black and white. I want it a yes or no. The full tones is great because it's a sliding scale depending on the conductivity of the target. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to put it on the two tones. I'm going to have the iron on 202 and I'm going to have the non-ferrous on 710, just to make it a crisp yes-no sort of program. All the other hot settings are exactly the same. Oh, one thing I've got to mention, because we're back into two-tone, we're going to have to put a little bit of discrimination on it. I reckon about 5, that'll get us going. So 5 on the discrimination. So I'm just going to put that in now, I'm going to fill this hole in and we're going to have a quick go. There you go. Nice sharp signal. I've put a little bit of iron volume on this. I've gone up to 3 as well. So it's disc 5, 2 tones, iron volume 3. Everything else is the same as the hot program. It's livened it up a bit. At last. Not really sure that what that is. It's not even. It's one end's thicker than the other and it's very, very pointed at each end. And I don't know if you can see that. There's a blob at the top. So could have been some sort of a brooch. I know I'm probably elaborating on this, but getting overexcited over something what isn't. But it's at the right depth. And again, 7 kilohertz is banging out the small stuff, the low conductive stuff. Yeah, I like that one. You know, sometimes with a target you get a feeling. Well, I've got that feeling with this target. There's just something about it, it's perfect. Still going, still sounding good. time for the Garrett Carrot. Bottom of the hole. Well, my feeling was absolutely right. It was a coin. Nothing exciting. Possibly a Georgian. About 10 inches down again, I'd say. Nice, smooth signal. There's something about that signal what was textbook. So that's our quick run out with two-tone. Keep the same adjustments. Back onto the audio menu, I'm going to put pitch on. So I'm going to let you hear what pitch sounds like. Now, pitch isn't for everyone. Takes a little bit of time to get your head into it, but it's a good way of telling what's iron and what's good. Let me show you. It's a nice repeatable sound. Pitch is a difficult one to explain. There's no tonal ID, it's an intensity sort of signal. Quiet ones are faint, shallow ones are loud, obviously. But what you've got to remember is the signal's got to be smooth, it's got to be continuous. If it's got a stutter to it, it's normally iron because the discrimination's breaking it up. If you can imagine a line of ball bearings, now they're going to be smooth if you run your hand down. If one's out of shape, or out of place I should say, it's not smooth, you can feel that hump in it. Crazy way of explaining it, I know, but it's a difficult one. So what you're listening for is a smooth yearning sound with no stutters. So, deep ones are faint, shallow ones are loud. And we've got quite a nice one there. Still in the hole. There you go, it's out, and it's really revved up. Part of an old spoon, I'd say. That's going back a fair bit. So, shallow targeting pitch. Screamer, deep one. It's called a VCO audio, voltage controlled oscillator. So, it's worth using pitch. I quite like it. It's good for identifying the iron, as I said earlier. But it might take you 15-20 minutes just to get your ear into it, because it's not like the conventional two tones. A lot of people are using pitch these days, especially with the big coil, when they're hunting for sort of large targets. I know the big coil is very popular in countries like Greece and even China. They're buying a lot of these big coils now because they just want the artifacts and the deep stuff. So there you go, let's see if we can find some other examples for you, and wrap it up very shortly. Okay, this is our last signal. I think we've got a storm coming in from behind us, so thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Perfect. Hey, bit of silver. Silver sixpence. Well, thanks for watching. That's a quick spin out with the XP Deus using a 13-inch coil. I'm really glad I stuck to 7 kHz because it found me some impressive targets at quite reasonable depths. Even small stuff at good depth. So, we based our settings around the hot program. We switched to two tones to make it a little bit more black and white. Then we went on to the pitch mode. The pitch mode, yeah, it takes a bit of getting used to, but give it a try. You're losing out if you don't try pitch mode.